research I presented was a collaboration with Professor Siegel's group from UCLA, and it started out as a coincidence because he looked at the number of hypocretin neurons in postmortem brains, so hypothalamic sections from deceased people, to look at the hypocretin system, and he found that some people had a really large increase in cell number, unexpected. Then he looked back to those people and he found out they were opiate addicts. So he looked at a mice model where he saw that if you give opiates to mice, the number of hypocretin neurons also increases. And we know that if you don't have hypocretin, so humans without hypocretin have narcolepsy, sleep disorder narcolepsy. So there are also mice with narcolepsy. So when he gave opiates to those animals with narcolepsy, their symptoms improved. So after this, we were very interested in these findings because this could also have clinical implications for not only for opiate users maybe and as an explanation for their addiction, but also for narcolepsy, maybe as a treatment for narcolepsy. So in the Dutch Brain Bank, where I work together with the Dutch Brain Bank, we have two people in the brain bank with narcolepsy, but one was a really strange, doubtful case that during the lifetime the symptoms became less clear. And when I looked at the sections, I saw hypocretin neurons. So we thought, well, this is not a typical case because there are still hypocretin neurons left. And then looking back at it, we found out this person had used opiates before her death, for a few years before her death because of chronic pain. And also her narcolepsy symptoms really improved, were almost maybe gone in that time period because there was doubt, but the clinicians had doubt, is this narcolepsy or not? So that was a really interesting finding. So we looked back at the brain and we counted the neurons, and it was like a 15% return of hypocretin neurons, you can say, compared to a typical narcoleptic brain where there are hardly any neurons left. So this raised the question, can this be a treatment for narcolepsy maybe? So we looked back at all the literature and we even found three case reports where opiates were given to a narcoleptic patient in an improvement of symptoms. And there was even a small trial performed, which was negative for sleepiness. But when we then read the whole paper, and not only the abstract, we found out that cataplexy, one of the symptoms of narcolepsy, actually improved after opiates. So combining all these facts is very interesting. So there are some older case reports and a small trial where there were benefits of opiates on symptoms of narcolepsy. And in this one case, we found a return, at least there was a 20% of a normal number of hypocretin neurons, where you expect none in a case from the Dutch Brain Bank. So that was what I presented. And then I ended with a call, like maybe we should study this. We are looking in our sleep center now to see what if our patients have any experience with this. Have they used opiates for another indication, maybe? So we found one patient that also described a dramatic improvement of symptoms after opiates for another indication. So now we're thinking about doing maybe a trial, but it's of course a little bit difficult with opiates and the whole problem of addiction. So we're now talking about that.